I'm going to say thank you, Jesus, for that. Come on, if you believe it, say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for another day, amen. Thank you, Jesus, for another Sunday. Thank you, Jesus, for another opportunity to get to gather in church. Thank you, Jesus, for the privilege to gather. Thank you, Jesus, for the privilege to worship together. God, let us not forget. God, let us not forget. 6 months ago, we were still only meeting online. 6 months ago, we were still 2 years deep in the meeting only online. Let us never become a casualty of familiarity. Let us never make it too familiar. Let us never take it for granted. We help each other together. I'm excited to hear my friends. My name is Preston Lingaton. I got a friend who said, want to welcome those of you online from wherever you're doing in the world. He's like, what are you? He's like, what are you? He's like, I'm sorry, I'm not going to lie. Before I get into it, I want to say something. I think that people are kind of all of our teachers when I'm training that I was a freshman, like, communicating about the Word of God. Every Sunday, I was a freshman to present a message, present a word that you can do God to get us in a time to turn down. So what do you mean to me? I was a freshman to present a message that you can do God to have a popular one. We love you so much. We love you so much. We want to help you so much. We want to be used by God so much. But our understanding is not to get into our words that we can do. If I can't use your words, that's not our primary objective. Our understanding is not to get into our words that is popular to people, but to get into our words that is pleasing to God. Can I tell you? Can you see that one of the things in my mind? It's not easy to deliver people into our messages. Because these kind of messages, they don't challenge you. They don't move you. Like, they love. They don't convince you. They might make you uncomfortable, or they might make you feel like they're a big trouble. And if you tell me, and you might be sitting here in the street, and you're doing a message that you're like, I don't want to. But if it's pleasing to God, if it pleases to God, if it is a message that supports you and makes you, moves you to the feet of Jesus, if someone gives you a chance to have, if you want it, you can tell them, go to Acts chapter 10 today. Acts chapter 10, if you want to sign it today. You sign it verse 9. If you want to give you a follow-up, and then when you say, take the next day, and for you, this is messages. We're here to follow. See you when the phone flash is to pray. It's all through if you were praying. But while you were thinking, you felt you were in strength. Because God has been something like a mushroom for you and sacrifices for you. Give it to you all sorts of family and friends when I was in church. And the Lord said to me, get up here, heal every soul of you. I've never been to danger that I was human strong, but I can't be human strength. But the point is to forget to not draw something under it to God's ability to bring it. The same thing is to bring it to the time. Yes, it's a time to do something that the fear of the very person, what Jesus is doing, do. It's not saying to them, it's saying to my children, follow the sign of the time. Standing outside the room, it's actually the man who is trying to do this and change it. The Lord of the Holy Spirit said to me, three men in front of the Lord, sit up, go downstairs, and go over there without any fear. Don't worry, for time is in. So, I want to make sure that my food is going to get situation and so that I can do it. Three wives, the Lord of the Holy Spirit, can hold this feeling to say to me, three men in front of the Lord, get up, go downstairs, and go with them without hesitation. Don't worry, for I am with you. So, I'm going to tell you all the things that I'm telling you without a fight. say in the session. We come to life. We come to something. It's a disobedient life. It's a divine life. We have to pre-COVID.
Thank you.
that is something to take into account. Or you can use those other terms. But even like raising life. So that would be something to continue serving with the serving or your serving. And that would be a thing that you can do like three, two, one. So the question is to ask yourself to do. It's just what's in your life. And so if you're getting yourself to talk about it, say it's easy to talk to you.
Come on.
so many of us are not thinking about life because we can't move it yet. And God is like, I'm waiting for you to move so I can feel right. Why are you supposed to do that? It's a process of obedience. That the reason we do what we do is what the Lord is instructing you to do becomes more and more clear. Now that we are home truly, the reason why we are home truly is because we want to be home truly. And what I'm saying is, the only thing that stops you from doing something does not mean that time is going to be true. I'm trying to say, you want to go from the job to the journey. You want to go from the job to the journey. So you can't stop yourself from doing it. I'm going to take a look at the first one. feel uncomfortable here. Like, I know I'm walking into traffic and I'm listening, so I'm feeling uncomfortable here all the time. But it's just something that you know is crazy in there. So I want to go with you. I want to go with you. We believe our kingdom is church is never forget, let us never forget. That you're instructing for nothing to think to. That you're instructing for all the things that you are telling people to do. And for all the things that you are telling people to do. And for all the things that you are telling people to do. And for all the things that you are telling people to do. We thank you for your son Jesus. 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 We thank you for your son Jesus.